Happy Wednesday, everyone. We got a fan favorite coming at you. We have our Core 5K Home Edition coming for you today. This may be the last time we get to do this, so fingers crossed, maybe we get one more month. I'm always looking forward to a chance to eke out one more month of this work set. But if we don't, let's make this one the best one. Our warm-up today is going to consist of a plank to bear squat for 3 to 5 reps, plank lean for 10 to 20 alternating, side lunge for 10 alternating, sumo squat for 5, regular squat for 3, and one narrow squat stand squat with a 10-second pause in the bottom. You'll do 2 rounds of that, and then we'll move down into the bottom here. Single leg RDL, 3 per side, unloaded or loaded. You'll move into 10 alternating back lunges, a dumbbell sumo deadlift high pull, 5 per side, and then you'll do a 100 to 200 meter run. 2 to 3 rounds there, get yourself fired up, get yourself ready. If you'd like to add in some skipping there for the work set, please do so as well. Then we have our Core 5K Home Edition. 30 minutes of work, or you finish the work set in 10 rounds. You have 10 rounds of work, single arm dumbbell sumo deadlift high pull, 15 per side, into a 200 meter run, and a 50 set of double unders, or again, I'll have some options for you on the workout description for the run and the double unders. So there'll be lots of options at the bottom. Check it out, make this one yours, you guys. A great little work set, good to get the heart rate going, those legs burning. So let's get you ready for action. All right, let's get you guys ready. Let's get those feet under the hips. We'll take the arms good and tall up overhead. Just gonna give ourselves a little shrug. Come back down with the shoulders. We're gonna take it all the way down the floor. We're gonna touch those toes, walk up the shins, come down, frame the foot. We'll step it back into your lizard. And from here, we're just gonna lower the knee, press the hip, straighten the leg, and straighten the front leg. We're gonna plant the foot, lower, press the hip, center, straighten, and straighten. Plant it one more time, lower, press, center, straighten, and straighten. Plant the foot, step back into our down dog. Setting those shoulders strong, we'll walk those heels out, nice and slow. Just make sure that everything feels good here. Nice and steady, nice and flowy through those ankles. And then from here, we'll come back into our plank. We'll step that other foot up, nice and square in those hips. We're gonna lower, press the hip, come back through, straighten and straighten. Plant the foot, lower, hip, come back through, straighten, straighten. One more time, plant the foot, lower, hip, center, straighten, and straighten. Plant the foot, step her back into that down dog. Setting those shoulders and walking those heels out. Nice and slow and steady. Finding that feet, finding that position. We'll come back into our plank. Tiptoe those feet all the way up. We're gonna roll ourselves up, big stretch, big reach, oh, come back down with the hands. Oh. All right, you guys, if you'd like to do some more kind of more casual kind of warm up, a little gentler stuff, maybe some wide stance good mornings or some dynamic triangles, you're more than welcome to take those down. Pause the video, add what you need in, come back to me, we're gonna get you guys fired up. We're gonna start off our day with our plank to bear squat. So we've been using this a little bit more in the past, in recent. So we're gonna get ourselves step into that plank position. Ribs and hips pulled tight, pressing through the shoulders. I'm gonna separate my feet into my squat stance, and I'm going to pull my hips straight back into my ankles, and then press straight out into that good plank. From here again, straight back into my ankles, straight back out into my plank. What I want to be focusing on as I'm pulling my hips straight back into my ankles is pressing down into the floor so my arms stay active all the way down so I can feel those lats and feel that core kick on as I'm pulling into that kind of squat position. Our goal is if you were in the bottom of that bear squat and I just picked you up, you'd look like you're in the bottom of a nice air squat. So try and get as close as you can. Again, ankles and hips are gonna kind of guide you through how deep you get into that position and also that shoulder stability. Once we're done our plank to bear squat for 3 to 5 reps, we're gonna move into our plank lean. So I get again into that tight position.
position, press through my shoulders. I'm gonna shift a bit, and I'm gonna shift a bit. Come back to center, make sure my shoulders are solid, and just shift back and forth. At any point during this leaning process, I feel my core turn off or my shoulders kind of sink and in between my scapula kind of give in. I can pause, reset my plank, get that good shoulder position either by dropping a knee or staying in my plank and just pausing in the middle so I can regain everything I need for my structure. So please keep that in mind. Don't just get through them with that shoulder starting to sink in on each other. Stay active, stay strong. After that, we're gonna stand ourselves tall. We're gonna work through some side lunges. So I'm gonna get my nice wide stance. This is also a nice time, if you didn't do any wide stance good mornings, to add some of those in as well. But I'm gonna try and take my hip to my heel, staying as upright as I can. So I'm gonna take it nice and slow and steady, just to wake up that ankle joint and wake up those hips. This is a great opportunity to work on our squat mechanics in a different type of position, because we still want to think about this building and opening up our ankles and our hips for our squat. So as I pull my hip back and down, I stay upright and tall. My ankle's gonna get a nice engagement through here, and I'm gonna allow myself to start working on my ankle mobility and my hip mobility for my squat. Because from here, we're gonna pull right into my sumo stance. And in that sumo stance, I'm gonna try and take my hips to my heels, staying nice and upright as I fall into that squat. So I'm gonna pull myself down, keeping my chest up, my knees pressing out actively so that they track the toes, a little bit more so than you normally would for a squat. All right, we wanna think about that as we stand up tall as well. So again, one more rep, hips to heels, weight through the midfoot, knees pressing out actively, staying strong through this whole posture position, and then drive through those feet to stand. Our next exercise is our regular stance squat. So I'm gonna bring my feet in from that sumo into my regular stance, which is gonna be somewhere from my hip to my shoulder width. All right, so I'm gonna turn to the side so you can see that as I squat, I stand tall. Again, hips to heels, a little bit of knee out pressure so my knees track the toes, my chest stays up, and I stay through that midfoot as I drive through my feet. You can add a tempo to these if you'd like, just to wake up your legs and ankles. You don't have to, but it's always nice in the warm-up, at least the first round of warm-up as well. From there, I'm going from my regular, anywhere inside my regular stance to find my narrow squat stance. In this one today, we're doing one rep with a nice, solid 10-second hold. So my hips are still gonna go to my heels. I am gonna be pressing my knees a little bit out so they track the toes, but more so gonna be focusing on staying upright and solid so my back stays flat and I stay active and weighted through the midfoot. It's very easy to fall backwards in that narrow stance squat, so we wanna make sure we're trying to keep our weight a little bit more forward, but still not venturing out of the midfoot where the laces are. So we should have flat foot contact, weight through the midfoot. Quick recap for you guys for that opening sequence. Plank to bear squat, 3 to 5. Plank lean for 10 to 20. Side lunge for 10, alternating. Sumo squat for 5. Regular squat for 3. Narrow squat for 1 at a 10 second pause. If you'd like to add a tempo into any of those exercises, please do so. Be my guest. I invite tempo work into our warm-ups for sure. 2 rounds of that. Pause it. Hit it up, you guys. Get yourself ready. I'm going to move into the next phase, which is going to be some single leg stuff, and introducing that sumo deadlift high pull. So we're starting off with our single leg RDL, so some stability for the knee and the ankle. What we're gonna focus on right now is just an empty hand variation. I have a dumbbell, which I'll show you what you can do with afterwards. I'm gonna pick my favorite leg for the day, find my balance points. I'm gonna hold my hands to the front like I have a dumbbell. My other leg is going to be kind of soft, loosely touching the floor so I can find my balance points, but dedicate my weight to my single leg. I'm gonna pull my hip back, just like a deadlift, staying square in hip and shoulder, taking those hands to the knee, and then stand tall. So it's very important that I initiate through my hips as I pull back, like a deadlift. So I'm working on that stability, working on that good position. Chest stays up a little bit more so than a back scale. If you wanna do this loaded, you are more than welcome to. And you can play around with a couple different variations of
I still get my foot set up the same way. I'm holding the dumbbell in front. I'm going to pull back with my hip, bringing my dumbbell to my knee, and then I push through that foot and I stand tall. I can also hold the dumbbell on the same side as the leg that's going back. So I pull my hip back, my hand is active on that side, I still take it to the knee and stand tall. Or I can hold the same side that is balancing, same setup, same initiation, pulling through the hip. The only difference is I really have to work on staying square through the body with the dumbbell on that side, because it's going to pull me to that side a little bit more so. From there, after the single leg RDLs, we're going to work on a back lunge. So I'm going to turn profile so you can see. I'm going to try and keep my body as upright as possible, and I'm going to try and keep my knee stacked under my hip, under my shoulder as I do this lunge. I step back and lower, and come tall. So I just want to make sure that I'm focusing on that nice step, lower, up action. Nothing too crazy here. We're just trying to work on some single leg stability and waking up those legs a little bit. If lunging is not your thing, you're like, I've been working on lunging, it's getting better, but I still have trouble with the balancing, there's nothing wrong with that. Set yourself up in your squat stance, and you can work on that standing lunge drill. So we have that nice tall position, 50-50 balance between the feet, and then we're gonna stand super tall and lower down and stand tall. Not having to worry about stepping and finding your footwork, we just have to worry about the control down and up. So it can help build the strength to build into those dynamic lunges where we can find our feet but feel confident that we're gonna be stable. Something key about those lunges that I always think about now to keep my knees stable is a little glute squeeze before I initiate the lunge. So if I'm standing here, I'll squeeze, make sure I'm focusing on squeezing and engaging my glute because I feel a lot more stable in that balancing leg and that leg that's going down. Same with that standing lunge drill. Squeeze your glutes hard first, maintain that engagement as we go down. After that, we have our sumo deadlift high pull. So we've been doing these a little bit in our warm-ups and workouts every once in a while. I really like it with the single arm, it's kind of fun. What we want to think about is setting up ourselves with a sumo deadlift position. So that gives me my stance, my feet are on either side of the dumbbell. I'm going to stand tall, pull back and down so I stay upright in my body, take hold of my dumbbell. I'm going to stand, using those legs and hips to get the dumbbell moving, and then I just finish with the arm, pulling it to the sternum and coming back down. I'm not holding it up here at all. I'm just hitting that position, controlling it down. So I pull back and down like a deadlift. I stand like a deadlift, but I build momentum through the hip to get the dumbbell moving. You'll notice the dumbbell just kind of flows up. The arm just guides it, keeps it close, and also finishes that momentum off to maintain the speed of the dumbbell. I'll turn to the side so you guys can see my back position. My back position is no different than a deadlift. I take it down nice and strong, nice and solid. I stand up, and I come back down. So the key is, we're not just gripping and ripping from the floor. We're getting that dumbbell all the way up, that full extension through the knees, through the hips, and then we finish the pull. Very similar to a clean in terms of the timing, right? The only difference is we're not pulling into a power squat, we're just extending and coming back down. So be patient with that pull, use those hips, use those knees, and allow yourself to get up. After the sumo deadlift high pull, we have a run or cardio piece of choice of 100 to 200 meters or 30 seconds to 60 seconds of work. Quick recap on that, we have a single leg RDL, 3 per side, back lunge for 10 alternating total count, dumbbell sumo deadlift high pull, 5 per side, and then a little cardio piece of about 30 to 60 seconds of whatever you're going to rock. 2 to 3 rounds of that, pause the video, take it down. Also, if you're looking at getting some skips in, throw some skipping into that warm-up and take her down and have some fun. The workout now, you have 30 minutes to finish, or you have 30 minutes to be like, yep, I'm good, I'm done. We're 30, we're good. You are gonna do 10 rounds of a single arm sumo deadlift high pull for 15 on one side, 15 on the other side, into a 200 meter run or cardio of choice, double under for 50, or again, a variation of that skip of choice. I'll have those options at the bottom of your workout description. They're all movements we've done before, all right? Easy modifications. We're looking for a good fast cardio piece here today. We don't want to have to think too much about this workout. We just want to go. So I want you guys to keep that in mind in terms of this work set. Have some fun with it, play for it, go hard, go kind of moderate depending on how you're feeling today, but let's just have fun outside and working on some good old-fashioned cardio. Until then, good luck with this one today. I hope we get one more opportunity to do it in November. You never know with the weather, fingers crossed. But good luck with it today. Work for quality, have fun, work hard. We'll see you very soon, everyone. Have a great day.